All right, everybody come together. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
I'd like to formally welcome you to the Chief Johnson's residence. And we're all happy to be here, isn't that? We're here to celebrate Tunde Johnson's graduation. All right, to kick the event started, I'd like to call to the microphone the first son of Chief Johnson, a very intelligent and handsome young man. Please jam your hands together as I call to the stage, Mr. Tunde Johnson.
All right, I want to say I'm really happy tonight. I want to appreciate every one of you for coming to spend time to celebrate with me. My first appreciation goes to my parents, Chief and Chief Mrs. Johnson. I think they deserve a round of applause. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Mommy, for spending so much on my education. And my second appreciation, of course, goes to my heartthrob, the lady of my dreams, my sweetheart, AKG. Can you just come up here? And I want to say, on behalf of two of us, we want to say thank you for coming. And when it's your turn to celebrate, we'll be there.
We'll be there
with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Another round of applause for today. At this time, I'd like to call an elder statesman, a captain of industry, an economic and commercial mogul, and a senior citizen of our nation. Please put your hands together for Chief Alfred Johnson.
Thank you very much, Mr. MC. I want you just to take a look at the person standing beside you. Tell him or her congratulations. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to sincerely appreciate you for honoring my invitation to my son's graduation party. On behalf of myself, my beautiful wife that is standing over there, my lovely daughter Sarah, and the celebrant of today, Tunde Johnson, I want to say a very big thank you to everybody here present. In fact, I'm elated. So please, I want you to roll out the drums. A lot of things to drink, a lot to eat. Just be free to yourself. Once again, you're welcome.
I think the chief deserves a louder round of applause. If I don't know Chief Johnson very well, I know that when it comes to socials, he's something else. Please appreciate it. Can we have a few hand glasses now? Three hearty cheers to Mr. Tunde Johnson. Hip, hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip, hip.
Hooray!
Now the very last one.
Hip, hip, hip.
Hooray!
I'm so proud of you. You have actually brought dignity and prestige to this family. Imagine you graduating with honors from the best university.
Thank you.
At least my son will be able to manage my huge investments.
Yeah, Dad, I must confess, you're one in a million, and I love you. I appreciate it.
Oh, that's good.
Thank you for all you're doing for me.
That's good. Just follow me.
Okay,
very slowly. Not so fast.
Okay.
Not so fast.
Okay.
I hope your eyes are closed.
Yeah, they are tightly closed.
Yeah, that's good. Okay. So here we are. Don't open your eyes yet.
Okay.
You can now open the eyes. This is your birthday and graduation gift.
What? For me, man? I'm so grateful. Mom! Mom! Nana! Mom, you guys! Dad just gave me the card.
Dad, I'm so grateful.
Wow. Sorry, I love this.
Hopefully,
Dad,
tomorrow be prepared to resume at the Venti Ventures as the chief executive.
Dad!
Proposal from Jack Farson Holdings. The client service manager brought it.
Oh, I see. Alright, call your manager and fix a meeting for 9 a.m. tomorrow.
Okay, 9 in the morning.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Hi, honey.
I miss you.
I'm fine.
I'm coming home tonight.
That's great.
I'll be spending some few days. Okay, okay. See you later.
Yeah, love you too. Bye.
Sarah.
Hi, Nkechi. You look beautiful.
Thank you. Nkechi? Yes.
Had wanted to see you.
Really?
It's nothing serious. You're such a beautiful young lady loaded with potentials.
Very sociable and amiable.
But in spite of all these qualities, you need one more quality to crown it all.
And what is that quality?
You see, you need to give your life over to Jesus.
I see.
Catch you there. One more thing.
What is that?
I'm happy that you want to marry my brother Tunde, but sleeping together before your wedding is a sin.
Beg your pardon?
It's a sin, my dear. Sex is only meant for marriage.
But I think it's one of those things.
Sex is only meant for marriage.
Ikechi!
Excuse me.
Sarah! How dare you? How dare you ask Ikechi to stop coming here? Who gave you the audacity?
But Ade has...
Shut up, please! Do you know how critical the marriage of Ikechi and Tunde is? Don't you know her father is the grandmaster of the G Connection? Wait till your father hears about this. Just mind your business and keep that SU thing to yourself. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Please!
Tunde.
Yes, Dad.
We need to talk.
I'm all ears, Dad.
As you can see, everything is working according to your desires. But you ain't seen nothing yet, my son. But you see, Tunde, there's got to be a continuity in this world. And let's not forget, did you check your bank account lately?
Yes, I did. I saw some huge deposits. I thought you kept them there for something else.
That is just your monthly bonus, my son. You're going to be having them in euros, hard currency, pounds sterling, dollars, and all these are going to be paid into your domiciliary account.
I have just started with you, my son. But Dad, the amount is too heavy.
Heavy, you say?
Yes.
Oh my God, you are just a kid. Like I said, you are just a kid. Now listen to me, my son. I want you to know that life becomes easy when you know how to play your cards. And remember, our elders say, when a child washes his hand clean, he dines with the elders. Tunde, I am going to take you to the next level.
Chief Douglas.
How are you?
I'm fine.
I'm fine. Good.
Hey, you meet with my son today.
Oh, the prospective member of
G-Connection.
You're welcome. Today, you are welcome to the connection of the Life Wire of the Nation.
That's right.
We are the movers and shakers of the nation.
That's right.
Here you meet Senator Prince, the majority leader of the Senate, and the chairman of the Operation Committee.
You're welcome, sir.
Come with me. Here is Chief Benson. You know him?
Yes, I do, sir.
Here is Professor Danny. And here you meet Dr. Stephen.
Oh, you're welcome.
Here is our justice here. Justice Kengo. And General Dan.
You're welcome. Yes.
As you can see, those young men over there, they are the future of the G-Connection. Their future is secured because they are connected to the life wire of our nation. They are the future managing directors, big businessmen, ambassador. You see, we are the unstoppable. You can meet with them.
That's my boy. So how are you?
I'm fine.
I'm sure you really enjoyed yourself this evening.
Yes, Dad.
I see.
And I want to say thank you. It was like a dream meeting and knowing those great men belong to the G Connection.
Tunde.
Yes, Dad.
You have not seen anything yet. You see, you have just started. That is the next level I was talking about.
Yes, Dad, can I just...
I hope you've not forgotten that the initiation comes up just some few weeks to this time.
No, Dad, I remember, and I'm ready for it.
I can see you're looking forward to it. Good night.
All right, sir.
I'll see you in the morning.
Good night, Dad.
See you later, eh?
Yes, Dad.
Tunde.
Ixis, I thought you should have slept by now.
Where did you go tonight?
I was in a great meeting.
The G Connection, isn't it?
How did you know that?
That society is a deep secret cult in disguise. If you join them, you will mortgage your eternity for mere materialism and fake human connection. So they come to Jesus now.
Look, you're getting it all wrong. It's not a cult. There was no fetish thing. There was no strange dressing. I mean, it was just a social clique.
Cultism is all about deception. A subtle way to eternal bondage. It begins with just social gathering and will later graduate to the real occultism. Tunde, don't be deceived. Don't join them.
Sarah, spare me. Do you think it's everyone that can be like you?
Please just spare me, eh? Let me live and enjoy my life the way I want to.
Tunde! Tunde!
Hey.
Auntie Doris, I still strongly believe that God has the power to restore your life again.
Dan, please, please. I don't want to talk about that issue again. I really feel I've disappointed God.
We all make mistakes. But God has the power to heal our wounds.
Dan, please, spare me. Can we pick another topic?
Yes, come in.
Hi, Daniel.
Hi, Sarah.
Good day, Auntie Doris.
Thank you.
How was your day, dear?
Fine. Excuse me.
Daniel.
Yeah?
Guess what?
What?
Can you believe that Daddy is trying to lure Tunde to join the G Connection?
What? Tunde?
He had attended the meeting with Dad. Though he has not been initiated, but a date has been fixed for the initiation.
No! It can't be. We have to stop it with serious prayers and intercession.
Well, I've told Sister Faith. We shall come together and pray over it.
Great. I will also see Pastor Alex today. And we are going to pray against it. Ah! Dee, I love that boy. He will be a great instrument in God's hand.
Amen. I have to go now.
Sarah.
Yes, Daniel.
The way your parents are behaving. Do you think they would not frustrate our relationship? I mean, your dad is just enduring me.
Daniel. Don't be moved by what you see. We're going to get married.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. But do you have any doubts in your mind?
Well, let's believe God.
Deceiving yourselves. Sarah's parents will not allow you to marry her.
Auntie Doris.
Sister Faith.
Yes.
The salvation of my family is giving me a lot of concern. The Lord has promised to save us and our household.
Yes.
But look at my dad, my mom, and Sunde. They just believe that having all the material things of this world is everything. Whereas the Bible says that, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Or what can a man give in exchange for his soul? Oh.
My sister is the same everywhere. Imagine Shade, my younger sister. She's a member of the campus cult, the Red Jezebel. A girl, for that matter. She's so aggressive, bold, and resolute. But we have to stand and pray and intercede for our families. that the devil can't take them just like that. We need to pray. Let's stand and pray.
Yo, man.
I'm feeling you.
We gotta go upstairs to do that now.
Go to the,
go to the, go to the, go to the, go to the, go to the, go to the, go to the, go to the.
As you know, we have gotten to the stage. One member moved to the next level. Senator Briggs, step forward. You want to proceed to the next level?
Yes, my lord.
You want to become the first citizen of your state?
Yes, my lord.
That's good. As you are aware, there is a price to pay for every level. Are you ready to pay the price?
Oh, yes, my lord.
Let's consult the great master. Aware of his initiation day?
Yes, my lord. In
In fact, he is actually looking forward to it.
Young fool. He doesn't know that the entrance of the connection is sweet, but the exit is bitter. You must make sure that he's here on the initiation day.
Yes, my lord.
If not, you know the consequence. Galaji!
Power! Dignity! Control!
You know, I gave you my number. Yeah. 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 You got some of these days. Yeah. Yeah. For real.
I'm gonna call you.
You say he's the one managing my huge investment.
Yes.
Wow. Out of my business.
That's big. Yes. He's a big man. He's a big man now, right?
And the lady beside him is Nkechi. That's the fiancé. That's the daughter of Chief Douglas.
Hi, how you doing? You're right here. Yeah. You lucky, dude. You lucky, bro.
Hello, Rose. This evening.
We study aeronautical engineering. Yeah. That's why I study back.
Yes.
I am a trained pilot.
Okay. So am I missing something?
Sarah, you're welcome.
You're welcome.
Sarah, you're welcome.
Thank you.
You came in just on time.
Yeah.
You see, actually, we are celebrating the arrival of Ambrose.
Yeah.
And that's the son of Chief Benson standing beside me here.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Yeah, it's a pleasure.
What's going on? This is Sarah, right?
Yeah, that's Sarah.
Yeah. Nice meeting Sarah. Yeah, how are you doing, though?
Right.
Yo. You need to take me out in Nigeria.
No, anytime you have time, just call me. I'm going to take you out of town.
Right. You owe me one.
Yeah.
You better promise me. In Nigeria. You know, if you were in the States, I was going to take you out.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we are all going to toast to the health of our son, Ambrose.
Thank
you.
Cheers.
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 Cheers, everybody. Cheers.
Cheers.
Yes.
So let more drinks roll. There are a lot of things to drink, a lot to eat.
Thank you.
Just be free. And let the drinks continue to roll. Caroline, I believe we still have more drinks around.
Yes.
Yeah, we're doing fine. You're looking quite yourself.
I'm trying to adjust.
Thank you.
It's me, Ambrose.
Oh, Ambrose, how are you? I hope you're gradually settling down in Nigeria.
You know how it is. We're just trying to adapt to the, you know, weather and everything. Look, Sarah, I need your help.
Really?
Yeah. Sarah, could you please come to Chicken Plaza by 7 p.m. tonight?
7 p.m.?
Yes, Sarah, 7 p.m.
Chicken Plaza tonight?
Would you be able to come?
All right, I'll give you a call.
That's a yes, right? All right then, I'll talk to you later. See you 7 p.m., right? Hi, sir.
Hi.
Please sit down.
Why?
Well, I'm sorry. I came very late. I was caught up in the holdup.
Right, right. I thought maybe...
No, not at all.
Hey, all right. Do you want anything to eat? Something heavy like a drink? Do you want a drink?
No, a drink will do.
Drink will do, right. Your waiter. Two glasses of orange juice.
Yeah.
On the rocks?
No,
my bad. I'm just joking. Yeah, ice for me and ice for the lady.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. All right.
You said you needed my help. What exactly do you want?
Right, Sarah. You remember the other day I came over to your house? And it was wonderful meeting Sarah. I find it so absurd when people find it hard them to find sleep when they just meet a lady they admire so much. But the same thing goes for me. I'm looking for sleep.
Why?
Look, Sarah, there's that perfect picture, right, that you fit exactly into. Look, there's so many girls in the United States, but they are so artificial. You're so natural. You're so composed. You're so admirable. You're so beautiful. You're so elegant.
It's okay.
So admirable. No. I'm not flattering you. No.
It's all right. Okay. Thanks for all your compliment. But I'm not the lady of your dream, and I can't. I'm engaged. I'm a child of God. Besides, I'm born again.
That's it. Thank you.
All right, everybody come together. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
I'd like to formally welcome you to the Chief Johnson's residence. And we're all happy to be here, isn't that? We're here to celebrate Tunde Johnson's graduation. All right, to kick the event started, I'd like to call to the microphone the first son of Chief Johnson, a very intelligent and handsome young man. Please jam your hands together as I call to the stage, Mr. Tunde Johnson!
All right, I want to say I'm really happy tonight. I want to appreciate every one of you for coming to spend time to celebrate with me. My first appreciation goes to my parents, Chief and Chief Mrs. Johnson. I think they deserve a round of applause. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Mommy, for spending so much on my education. And my second appreciation, of course, goes to my heartthrob, the lady of my dreams, my sweetheart, AKG. Can you just come up here? And I want to say, on behalf of two of us,